Hey guys, in this quick video we'll have a look at the new Tower 14 for Mac, which enables you to create custom Git workflows. We think it's a very exciting feature that many of you will use on a daily basis. Tower 14 is currently in beta, so to try it out, make sure you switch to the beta channel to download the latest update. And if you're not a Tower user yet, don't worry, you can still download our 30-day trial to explore this release. Alright, let's get started! So I just launched Tower, and the first thing you'll notice is that we have moved the Workflows button to the left-hand side, next to the Services and Bookmarks view buttons. In this demo repo, you can see we have Main as our base branch, and Feature and Hotfix as our topic branches. So let's click on Workflows and see what's new. So in here we can select our workflow, we can ask Tower to automatically detect our branch configuration by choosing the first option, but we could also pick Graphite, GitFlow with the external CLI tool, a custom GitFlow with our own preset which does not require an external tool, and either GitHub or GitLab Flow with our own templates as well. Let's pick auto-detected flow and see what happens. As you see, Tower correctly detected Main as our trunk branch and also created two topic branches, Feature and Hotfix. I could add more base branches or topic branches by clicking on these buttons, and I could also change the name of the trunk branch or any of these topic branches. If I now expand my topic branch configuration, you see I can select a parent branch, I can also select a starting point, and I could define my upstream or downstream merge strategies. For upstream, it could be a merge or a rebase and merge or a squash and merge, while for downstream, it could be a merge or a rebase. You can also decide if you'd like to always create a merge commit or not, as well as creating a tag when merging upstream. This looks like a great starting point, so let's click Save. Now you can start a new topic branch by simply clicking the Workflows button. You can see we can either start a feature or a hotfix right away. This will create a branch automatically for you and check it out immediately. Let's imagine you've already completed the feature and committed your changes. It is now time to finalize the feature so it can be integrated back into the main branch. You can either click the Workflows button again and select Finish, or choose the appropriate option from the context menu by right-clicking on the branch. In this dialog, you can change your merge strategy, create a merge commit, and decide whether you'd like your local branch to be automatically deleted or not. And there you go, our commit has been added to the main branch, and our feature branch has been successfully deleted. Now, let's think of a different scenario. Say there were some changes added to the main branch while you've been working on your feature. Since Tower knows the parent branch, it will let you know that your feature branch needs to be updated so that you integrate the latest changes. This is especially handy for those long-lived feature branches. By clicking on Update Branch, Tower will integrate all the commits from the parent branch into the feature branch. Once again, you can choose your preferred merge strategy, and if any merge conflicts occur, Tower will inform you in this dialog. Voila, your feature branch is up to date. It is also important to know that you can right-click any branch at any time and set a different upstream or parent branch to track. To learn more about Tower 14, check out our blog post. The link is in the description. We hope you enjoy this release. Happy committing!